Alright. I'm careful with this and don't touch the fins. I'm going to start on the lower part of the fish here, his jaw and his belly. And I'll work out to the fins. That's the plan. So, here we go. Alright, I didn't grab a whole lot because I'm gonna put this in a little more careful. Eyes get a little tired and have to back up a second and refocus on these things. A little more fine tuning here, so trying to be careful. Time because I want to put in a little bit of them scales in here too. On the underside. Because that'll go smooth. I'm just gonna go on some scales here. And I got a little spot up here I'm gonna do too. Not real happy with that. Kind of deep right there. Scales. Still gotta be able to see them. Alright. Picking this up in here. This one goes together. Still got that branch down in there, right up in there. Come in there. Make that look right. And I don't want to touch his belly there. It's going to go right underneath there.
tune this. Scales in there going on. That'd be smooth here going back. So I want this smooth. Now we're going to start in our scales. Bring them all in, blend them, make them look like they never was touched and all was done one time. That's the ticket. All these are bullet scales. These are all down. Alright. Now we're going to figure out some fins. This is where we got to be careful. I'm going to put us some fins in there. Fact, when you pile it on, it tends to want to hold the palette nice, so you gotta watch. You get a whole lot of damage real quick. We ain't gonna do that. Trying to keep it on there and not pull it out real quick. Not real easy. Not easy at all. Just put some more on there, we'll work it out. We also got to keep in mind we got the hump. Two of the muscle attaches, so a little extra match, yeah. So like that. We'll work that into you. So like that. Alright. Let's do us a fin now. Alright. Let's do the muscle. Keeping in mind that we're coming forward, so throw that muscle in, leave that muscle in there. Bring that fin. To the scales. good. There's one. Just gotta get number two. Just put plenty extra on there. So we're gonna stick them out anyway. And that makes it a lot easier to move it around too. This muscle. Start to spin. Whatever extra I just pull into the muscle. Still gotta build that little bit of tree in there. So I'm gonna try to work that in. Try to get a little round bead in there. Not pull everything out. Yeah. Okay. All of our scales are working. That one on the top, I need to get some of that. I'm not happy. Not happy with that. I feel like I'm just a little too deep on one scale there. Not happy with that. Take a second to fix it. Next, I need to fill this in. And of course, touching the vest a little bit and filling these little areas so it'll flush. This is already dry. This is from the last round. Just need the appearance of flesh, a little texture in here. That's all we need. Remember, this is going to dry. Problem. Just got that flesh in there. All the time experimenting around. I might do this one way. Next time do it another. Case by case. Always experimenting around. Nothing wrong with experimenting. Get any better at trying new things if you don't. Just a little bit under that curve. Because I wasn't happy with that. In there. So now I need to put a little angle of flesh right there. Okay. There we go. course is growing really good, so things kind of invented. There we go. And might want to get a little further towards. Square it up just a little. These are heavy on the bottom of your jaw. There we go. I think that'll work. It took a few days. Probably about 3 days to let this dry in. And I'll just keep trucking. I can't go ahead and put a lot of this over in the meantime if I want. But I got another penny here, both I'm working on too. So. That'll be it for right now. I'll come back at it again.